Hello, everybody. The purpose of the speech is to convey the importance of how our prison systems have been developed, and I'm trying to convey this message that we should move from punishment to rehabilitation. Our nation has the largest number of prisoners incarcerated in the world. We house over 2 million, felons or prisoners, in our county jails or in our state and federal correctional facilities. Some facts to point out is that we have over 1,800 state and federal correctional facilities. As well, we have over 3,200 local, from the local and county jails. So, one out of every 110 people in America go to jail. And the problem is that it's a repeating cycle that we need to stop, or has to be stopped, that people go in and come out and they're not being rehabilitated, they're not being trained, they're not being taught, how to live a normal life in society. And every circumstance is different for every individual. Some individuals can pick it up quick, some individuals have a harder time. And it all has to do with, their lifestyle. A lot of them didn't have a choice of how they grew up or where they grew up. Others, had a choice, had a better, upbringing in their family. But it's just a matter of choice. I wanted to share something from an article that I read from the New York Times. The title is "What Should Be the Purpose of Prison," and this was written by Michael Gonchar. So he said that jails across the country have become vast warehouses, made up primarily of people too poor to post bail or too ill with mental health or drug problems to adequately care for themselves. So we have this trend of people that, I'm not saying they're being targeted, but are most likely to end up in jails or in prisons because, like I said before, because of their upbringing. It can be they have mental health issues and they don't have the proper, health insurance, they don't have Medi-Cal, or they don't have the money to attend these needs. A lot of them have problems with drugs, so there's just a repeating cycle for them. Another article that I want to share, it was called "Prison: To Punish or to Reform." I found this article in PBS by Robert E. Roberts. He is the founder and executive director of Project Return of Louisiana Incorporation. Now, in his statement, this is what he said: "What I would say is that the environment of prisons should be model in every way how we want prisoners to behave upon their release. We'd like them to have respect and compassion for others and respect for the law." So this individual, what he's saying in the rest of his article is that the system is built up and they're being treated in a way that it's not a humane. So basically what I'm saying is, like, we're sending these people to prison, that's fine, to get punished, but we're expecting them to be respectful when they come out. We're expecting them to have compassion when they come out. But these jail facilities or prison facilities are not doing that. These prison or jail facilities are treating them like animals, are treating them like garbage. And so this is a standard ideology or standard belief that, saying that all society, but you know, many people from society look at prisoners or inmates or people who go to jail as lower, you know, less classified druggies, people that have issues. So we have no compassion for them. So when they go to these facilities, you have people who are there, you know, the staff, the guards, the security guards that, you know, monitor them. And, you know, I'm saying that all of them, but some of them could be disrespectful. Some of them could treat them, you know, inhumane. So this is why, you know, the rate, you know, for a prisoner that comes out is so high for them to go back to prison. And the rate is about 67%. So that means that 67 out of 100 inmates that get released, 67 of them will come back within 3 years. Now, the question is, you know, what can we do to stop this cycle, to stop this from evolving more? We're already at a high capacity, over 2 million, you know, adults being detained in jails and prisons. And not only that, but all the money that we're spending in there, to, depending on the state, to house an inmate, it's anywhere from $30,000 up to $80,000. And what the people are spending, the taxpayers are spending a year, it's, you know, it's $64 billion that we're spending into facilities, that we're spending into housing for these inmates. So it's a couple of solutions, you know, that I've thought and that I heard of is making programs that would, you know, that are intense for these individuals, programs that will help them, you know, see their errors, see their mistakes. And not only that, you know, but just having compassion for people in there, you know, makes it a big impact in their lives. You know, when you try to, you know, be aggressive or tell them that they have to change, it's like you're dealing with people that are not psychologically, you know, fit. You know, they can't think right, they can't reason right. So you have to have some kind of special trained, you know, psychologists, special trained counselors to deal with these people. So there is one program that I found. It's called Life Connection Programs, and it's an 18-month program that it's based to lower the rate of prisoners returning back to prison. And the rate is it's better. So the program entails basically monitoring your actions, monitoring your thoughts, and after you monitor them, it's finding a way to, you know, a healthy way to manage how to deal with life. You know, most of these people would deal with anger, you know, drug addiction, violence. So it's a way to deal with all these things in a healthy way that would benefit society, that would benefit, you know, themselves, and that would benefit their families. So instead of investing so much money into, you know, just so they can be housed, like just a warehouse, you know, we need to invest money into where programs are created that will change their lives, that would make a significant impact, where, you know, these people will come out and they would be, you know, our voice in society that would reach out to the younger generation. This could only get better if we put the effort into rehabilitation and to rehabilitate these inmates. It would only be a more positive effect for society. It would be less crime. It would be more voices, you know, out to the gangs, more voices out to the drug addicts, more voices out to, you know, people who maybe they can prevent from going into that direction. And what we can do is that, you know, we can just get informed. You know, the laws are being passed, you know, every year. So the more we can get informed on how the prison system works, what's being done, while an inmate is there, makes a big impact in the way we see the inmates. It can change our whole perspective if only we would just, you know, get knowledge, get informed of what's really going on. So that's all I got. Thank you.